Hi everybody and welcome to the latest video. Today we're going to explore the new K Plus Black Tough resin from Resione. Resione was so kind to send me a sample of this resin. As I said, it's a tough resin. It's got a nice black color to it. Resione says it has nice mechanical properties. On the website description, you will find that it is non-dusting, non-powdering, non-scratching surface. And of course, I'm gonna test it with our action figures. Now, something that really strikes me as odd is that there are hardly any videos or video reviews, resin video reviews out there that deal with this aspect of powdering, dusting surfaces, especially given the fact that nowadays you have so many different resins with mechanical properties, but not many of them are considering the fact that you need a non-scratching surface. So there's just a rare selection out there of few resins that have these nice non-powdering, non-dusting, non-scratch surface properties. So anyway, I hope this is going to be another one of them. Hopefully a good example. We will see. One more thing I found very interesting is usually the other resins have a 2-year expiration date. Now this should be good for 3 years, which is kind of interesting. Okay, so let's get into the detail of things. I printed out several of our action figures, the usual stuff, because what I'm interested in is how do our snap fit joints hold up. And for that to work perfectly or properly, you need a nice resin or resin mix. So this test is purely considering the advantages for 3D printed action figures. We're not gonna do any durability tests or anything like that. So to start with, there's the exo armor files. We have the heavy exo armor suit, and this is the exo armor pilot. I printed all these tests with the recommended settings by Resione. I just used a 3-second layer exposure, post cured them according to their recommendations, and then I just let the cured and dried resin sit for a few days and then assembled this figure. So what I noticed first is it is really, I would say, scratch resistant. It looks good. There was a little bit of scratching because this side I assembled directly after the curing. And I think this was a bit too early maybe. I don't know if there was some residue from the washing. I didn't really use a clean container of IPA. So this could be residue from other resins. But however, fully hardened after a few days, you can see the difference here in this hip joint. The right side joint is really scratch free. So I guess it would be a good measure to let them dry for a day or two before you assemble a snap fit figure like this one. So this is a bit loose because I think the exposure is too low. I mean, it's a very dark resin, so I would assume it needs a longer layer exposure time, but assembly went quite well. So anyway, you can see it's more like a ragdoll feel to this one. I'm gonna assemble another figure and see how that holds up. So let's see, this is already removed from the runners and cleaned up, and let's start assembly. Goes together well. Okay, also a bit loose. Yeah, as I said, the exposure setting was probably too low this time, but even dried and sitting for a few days, the assembly is quite nice. Pops in nicely. There's no surface scratching, dusting, powdering so far. It's very good. Yeah, holds up well. I assume for this kind of resin, it would probably take maybe 4-second layer exposure for really nice and tight joints overall. So this is also a bit loose, but it works well. No scratching, no powdering. So I would say Resione, as promised, delivers a nice new resin with nice tough properties. What I really like about this resin is the way that the prints break loose from the support structures. It's really, really easy to remove. There's almost no effort. With other tough resins, I usually use these clippers. But here, you can simply pull it out. You can just remove the leftover supports by hand. It's very nice. Of course, you would do it properly. There would be some cleanup required. But just like quick and dirty testing works very well. So now what's really interesting is always this helmet part. That's why I like to use this figure for my resin tests. because this is a very, very, very small hinge, as you can see. So the resins I use usually require some flexibility and toughness at the same time, but it can't be too flexible, otherwise this joint will wear out quickly and then the visor of this helmet will just pop off with no effort. So, nice little click. And oh yeah, oh, this is really nice. Okay, the helmet works perfect with a 3-second layer exposure. This is awesome. All right, here we go. The shock is a little bit loose in the hip. Had a hard day, poor bounty hunter. It's tough. Believe me, it's tough. So, let's move on. We also have the Exo Armor suit. I haven't printed these in a while, but let's see. Let's test it if they come off as easy as well. Okay, nice, nice, nice. All seems to work very well. Foot, upper arm, lower arm. Okay, this is nice. We have some supports in here at the grip I have to remove with the scalpel. Works very well. This side. I really like how easily these prints come off the supports. And there's hardly any residue. Like this, wow, check this out. It's like injection molded. There's no residue. I just pulled it off. No residue, I don't see the connection points. Ah, here, okay. But this is, okay, you can see a little bit, but focus. Yeah, but not too much. This is nice. Okay, let's continue. More parts. Easy. Easy, easy, easy. Okay, also nice. This is a bit tricky because this is a very thin connection here. And this is something I usually wouldn't remove just like this from the supports because it can break easily. But this worked well. Some additional supports inside the joint I have to remove. Also down here, inside. So another leg just comes off. Nice. Awesome, great resin. The shields. And let's take a few hands. Right hand closed. We have an open left hand. Yes, here. Some supports flying away there. And the gun. Nice. Good, small gun. Let's take this one. Enough. Okay. So, and of course, we got the katanas. Ah, no. Exo armor should go without a katana. So, okay, let's put them together. Let's see how it snaps or not. I'm sure it will not break. Keep my fingers crossed. Oh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Good tough resin has some flexibility to it. That's important. Seems to come together very nicely. Wow, yep. Very good fit, very good fit. So this, the Exo Armor seems to work very well with a 3-second exposure with this resin. So it's just a reminder, it might be a good choice to print the Exo Armors and the accompanying pilot action figures separately. Different layer exposure settings. Seems like, in this case I just have the feeling that it's something, well, okay, good. You see now here, the foot joint is very loose. So the 3-second exposure didn't work very well for the foot joint. Okay, so maybe 4 seconds. Maybe 4 seconds is the better choice. Would be the better choice. Anyway, let's continue. Second foot is done. Now for the arms, just see. Oh, by the way, while we're at it, a few people had some problems with assembly of the Exo Armor suits. There's a tiny, minuscule detail here. I don't know if you can see it, to tell apart the left side shoulder armor from the right side shoulder armor. In the front part of the left side shoulder armor, there's a small dent here on the inside. There's a very small dent. And this corresponds with a bump on the front arm biceps. Don't know if you can see it here, this little bump. So if you put that on, so that should snap on. The dent has to be on the inside of the shoulder armor, and that should pop right onto the bicep. So I'm probably going to add some markings on the armor in the future. I think that's the better way, of course. But anyway, for now, this is how it works. Yeah, this works well. So other side. I really like how those parts come together with this resin. Very nice quality indeed. Very nice quality. Oh, such a good fit. Okay, really good fit. Really, really good fit. That's the only downside with the action figures. If you print at a lower layer exposure, of course you have perfect fits for the parts, the tolerances of the parts, they are all perfect. But unfortunately, for real nice joints, you need some grip. And you actually need a higher exposure setting because, you know, some resins also tend to shrink over time and you never know how they exactly behave. You have to test this, but for action figures it's always better to print at a higher layer exposure setting. Anyway, this is something for experimenting. I mean, you need to find your favorite resin, the resin you're most comfortable with, the resin you think works best for you, and then find the right settings. It's not rocket science, but it takes some time. Anyway, I've seen good results out there, so, I mean, what am I saying? I think your people know what you're doing. So, oh yeah, the wrist is quite tight. That's a good thing. And here we go. Oh yeah, this works nice. Oh, there comes. It's all a bit loosey wobbly, but I can still get it to stand upright. All right, now for the katana, we're gonna do one stress test. So the katana has some flexibility to it, and now I want to see how far can I take this resin. And therefore I'm gonna put my hand here. I don't want to. It's flying off into my eye or so. Okay, this looks good. This looks good. Wow, okay. Katana bent all the way. Does it come back? It didn't break. Yeah, comes back. Needs a little adjustment, but it comes back. Almost straight. Right. Yep, it's a good resin. If you like black resin, I would definitely recommend it. I'm not a big fan of black resin, I have to say. I like more the gray stuff. I'm perfectly happy with that. But if you like the black resin, or also you could use it in a resin mixture. I found out that the Resione resins, they mix superbly. I've been experimenting with all sorts of mixes, like M58, Anti-Impact, TH72. They all produce great results. So I haven't tried mixing the K Plus Black Tough resin yet, but sure, why not? I mean, if you want to have a darker tint of gray, for example, M58 is quite light. It's a very light gray, very less translucent, looks very nice. You can see the surface detail, but if you want to have a bit darker, I assume the Black Tough would be a nice addition. Could try it in a mix, or can mix it with Anti-Impact, which is very light and translucent, to get like a light gray result. So possibilities are endless. Yeah, well, that's it. That concludes our video for today. And yeah, give it a try if you're interested. Check it out. It's a good resin. It's got great surface properties. The detail is really, really nice, by the way. Right, thanks again to Resione for providing me this sample. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and if you did so, please leave a like and subscribe to support the production of more content. Thank you very much, and see you next time. Bye.